I do apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen. I have no idea what the hell caused that crash, but kind of ironic that my game crashes inside of a game that talks about games crashing. I hate when that happens, though. But at least it didn't happen in the middle of a boss fight. I hope the people that were in my last video come back. Welcome back. I'm sorry about that. I have no idea what the fuck happened. So I was reading a message that one of my friends sent me on Messenger.
Yes.
But yeah, if you guys have any questions, feel free to ask. I know, but I still feel bad though. So I just started playing this a while ago because it, like I said, it was the free game for PlayStation Plus members for July. So I'm starting to get into it because I love how the music is. I love how it's like, you know, think on your feet, action packed. And you can customize your own character to a certain degree. Woo, full team of players. Fuck yeah. I mean, it is crossplay compatible.
Yeah.
I also play other games for different systems. I also play Monster Hunter World. If you want to get into that, I do have a playlist where you can watch that. You can find most of my playlists of games I've played in my YouTube. Not a bad gamer. Even I get stuck in some of my games. I also play Genshin Impact. That's on PC and it's free to play. But unless you're a certain level, you can't play with other players until you get past a certain level. Oh, I don't have enough to say that. But yeah, once you get to a certain ranking in Genshin, which is AR-16, you can get to that within, I mean, if you play religiously, like, every day, you can get there in, like, a couple of days. And it's fun, but it does take up a lot of your time. It's one of the games, listed in my personal opinion as a no-life game. And I haven't gotten any of these yet. I haven't froze anyone. I haven't closed any beta breaches yet either. But yeah, I also play Call of Duty, Black Ops, but I only play zombies. I'm not playing story mode. Fuck that shit. I cannot wait till my new ghost thumb guards get here. What the fuck are you two doing back here? The first stage and you already want to boost it to 3? Are you fucking nuts? Oh,
Hi, buddy.
Oh shit, out of ammo. Oh, that explains a lot. One dude left. Oh no, the other dude's still here. But yeah, like I said, I love the music. What the fuck are you doing? Why we can't have nice things. The game as a whole is fun. There is a story, but then again, the story is connected with the mini missions you do throughout the game. There are eight stages. And depending on your team composition and how well you mesh together, you could either get from stage 1 through 8 perfectly fine, or you might not get all the way to the end. The boss fights are fun too. If anybody wants to jump in the box, feel free to let me know. Also, mini games in this game, too. I should have bought my fucking freeze gun. Oh, okay, that gave me ammo for this motherfucker. Even teleport that far.
Thank you.
Also, the currency in this game. The currency in this game is coins, but also that's just the minor currency in this game. The major currency in this game is tickets. And you can get tickets from doing all sorts of... Oh shit, I am... Nope, fuck, I fucked up. I'm an idiot. I fucked up, I should not have jumped. The main currency of this game are tickets, which you can get from various things, from... Mostly from beating levels. You don't have to fully complete them. You get tickets based off the amount of points that you've earned throughout your entire run. Also, I'm still baffled that people like my voice. I don't know. I want to know. What is it that people like about my voice? Woo! 3-in-1! I mean, I'm glad you think it's friendly. I've had people tell me that I shouldn't use my voice because apparently it's intimidating. I'm glad it's friendly, though. Consequences of my actions chasing me right now. Shocker weapon level up. Whee! I need to close 10. No, sorry. I need to close 10 of these breaches. No. Oh, shit! I didn't know I wasn't gonna make that. Stage 2 complete. But yeah, you can get tickets from either completing challenges, progressing through story mode, which is technically stage mode. But if you die in the game and you can't continue, don't worry, it's okay. You can just restart the entire run, and it gives you a chance to earn more tickets so you can buy stuff. I need to find more games that are cross-play compatible and play with people. I know this game is. I know Borderlands 3 is. I know Genshin Impact is one. Dauntless. I know Dauntless is one. Pretty sure there's no enemies left over here. Nope.
Thank you.
heal allies for 500 500 points of health. Follow the chain of destruction that everybody leaves behind. I hope that was orbital strike, but that's so fucking cool. Stage 3 complete. Excuse me. Well, I mean, at least I'm in third place. I love cinnamon bears. I gotta get 30 surge ability kills. Which means I may have to do a solo run for that one. This whole thing's about closing data breaches. I need to close like 3 more. Fuck this shit, I'm out. And I'm back in fourth place. Could have sworn I had an energy drink left, and I can't remember what the fuck it is. Oh. That coin glitch. How is he just standing? Okay, that's where that one was. That's stage 5 out of 8. Whew. Is it possible? Can we go all the way to stage 8? Okay. Alright, sorry about that. I just don't want to have my face on camera for me just staring at the screen and you guys just confused as hell. Discombobulated as fuck. Oh, and I jinxed myself. Thank you. Thank you, kind stranger. Fuck it. Fuck. Hey, Skittles. Wanna get in the box? I don't know where the fuck I'm going. Where's the exit? That's it. There it is. Okay, now I gotta send out the fucking re-invites again. Forgot how long stage 6 was. Hello. Did you get any sleep yesterday, or did you stay up all night again? I was about to say, you better have gotten some sleep. You're stressed. Hello. What's got you stressed? Oh no, I just leave. Like, if I don't know the motherfucker who added me, I'm leaving. Oh. Oh, okay. Ah, I see. It's kind of like the first day of school. Do this. There we go. Ooh. Ah, that hurt. Oh, I'm getting old. Because, like, if, I mean, honestly, if you're a dog groomer, then dog groomer's in high demand. Especially during, like, the summer and the winter. Like, holy shit. Especially the big dogs. Whoo! So. I mean, you could, but it wouldn't come out as well. You need that personal touch. So, I don't have an official job. I do odd jobs for friends, and they pay me whatever they think my labor is worth, and some pay good, some don't, because, you know, bills suck. But during the summer, it's hit or miss for me doing odd jobs with friends, because some of them go on vacation during the summer, but when they go on vacation, I'm usually not available because, you know, I'm off doing something and I can't just drop everything just for a job. I had people ask me to house sit for them. Like, okay, cool, are you gonna give me a ride to and from your house? No, you can take a lift. Then I'll charge you extra because that's my money coming out to do this. And this dude was like, yeah, I need you to watch my two big dogs. And they're like St. Bernard mixes. And I'm like, okay, cool. You know, that is $60 for a big dog plus food, because I do have to go out and get the food if they eat a lot. And then, you know, walks. I'm not gonna charge you for walks. Like, if when I gauge a price, it has everything included. Like, if you ask me to watch a chihuahua, I'll charge you $40, depending on how long you want me to watch them for. But if it's a big dog, like a Saint Bernard or a Great Dane, I'm gonna charge you $60-$70 per dog. And he's like, I'll give you $20 and you can use my cable. I'm like, sir, that's not how this works. If you wanted somebody to do it for $20 in cable, you're gonna have to call one of your friends. And he tried to cheat me out of the money. Like, he wasted, and this is what pisses me off. Like, if you're gonna talk to me about business, talk to me about business. Do not waste my time on it. He spent 45 minutes telling me that I can do it for $20 and I should be grateful for the job opportunity. I said, oh, it gets worse. So he wanted me to watch both St. Bernard mixes, and they're not the puppies, they're full grown motherfuckers. And they live, and they, so they basically sleep inside, but they stay outside most of the day. Outside is a fucking desert. There's no grass, none of that shit. It's just dirt mounds. And he's like, okay, you know what? I'll pay you $20 and you can use my cable. That should be good enough. I'm like, no, because I do not know you. I do not know your dogs. The $60 per dog, it's not for just your safety. It's for mine too. That's insurance. Because if your dog bites me, I'm not gonna be one of those dudes that, you know, blows a whistle. No. I'm gonna be one of those dudes that manhandles your fucking dog. I will not whistle. I will not hurt them. I will walk up to them and look at them like, no, you cannot do that. I don't give a fuck if they give you back sass. I'm not gonna hurt the dog. But I will tell the owner, oh yeah, these are my list of expenses because I had to watch your fucking dog. And he's like, okay, fine, $60. I'm like, for one dog, I can do that. But that's just for watching the dogs. And watching the dogs includes walkies, food, water, you know, all that shit. If you want me to cuddle your dogs, and if your dogs are high maintenance like that, you want, they need cuddle, cotton, etc., that's extra. And he's like, okay, how much would it be for both dogs watching them for 2 days? I'm like, okay, let's see. Two dogs, that's 120 flat out for both dogs. To stay, if I'm, am I staying at your house? No, I'll give you a spare key, but you have to give it back when I get home. Okay, spare key. I'll let that one slide. But to get to and from your house, depending on where you live, I'd have to take a lift to and from your house. And he told me he lives at a certain town not too far away. So I gauged it. I'm like, okay, that's $45 there, $45 back. That's $90 round trip. Times that by two. That's 180. So multiply 180 plus 120. And he's like, that's 400. That's like 400. I'm like, yep. That's not including... that's not including the insurance I need to place on you, which is a $200 deposit because I don't know your fucking dogs. And he's like, see, you know what? And then he said something that really got me. He's like, geez, no wonder why no one's paying for your services. You charge an arm and a leg. I'm like, that's for my safety, not yours. You live with them. They don't know me. They could bite me. And I don't want to hear you say, oh, they're sweet, precious angels. They'd never bite anybody. They won't bite you, but they will bite me. That's some bullshit. Don't get me wrong. I love animals. I love dogs. I flat out told him, like, I'm not watching your dogs for $60 in total. It's either you pay me the $400, you will get the $200 deposit back if I do not get bitten. If I get bitten, that's my insurance fee. And if you want someone to watch your dogs for $20, you better go get your motherfucking friends. I mean, at least you're extreme helpful. Because your body was hurt? So, there's a reason why I have, there's a reason why I have a $200, fee. It's because before I actually started implementing the big-ass fees I have, I used to do things, you know, I used to do it for, like, $20. So I'm like, shit, it's fucking money. But I came across, this person's dog, not fixed, not trained. This dog was a humper. And the fucking owner named him Glenn. And I'm like, no, that's Humphrey. And while I was watching the dog, like, I tried my best to keep the dog away from me because he didn't even warn me the dog was in heat or any of that shit. And, like, I'm like, you know what, fuck it, $20, all I gotta do is watch him for a couple hours, that's it, that's all, I get my money, I go home. No. This motherfucker told me 2 hours, 3 max. No. No. Motherfucker was gone for 6.5 hours. Finally comes home, and I'm looking at him. I'm like, I'm gonna have to charge you extra because your dog has a problem. And he's like, no, dog is not a problem. My dog is the sweetest dog. I'm like, your dog humped me and finished on my fucking pants. And he's like, well, I don't know what the fuck you did to my dog. I'm like, no, no, no. We're not playing this. Your dog's a motherfucking victim card. You need to get your dog trained. He does not listen to any of the commands that you told me to give him. That's on you. You should have had him fixed. Again, that's on you. Well, where's my dog? He jumped out the fucking open window that you left in your bedroom. You are a negligent pet owner, and you do not deserve to have any pets. Guess what happened? He's like, he wouldn't let me go home until his dog was home safe and sound. His dog didn't come back home till almost midnight. And his dog, it was an open window, and he ran out into the backyard, and that was the last I saw of him. Until midnight. That motherfucker kept me hostage. Till midnight. And then when his dog came back, his dog was limping. And he's like, what the fuck did you do to my dog? I'm like, sir, you are this close to getting punched. One, listen to when I say this very carefully. Your dog jumped out the window you left in the out in the back of the house. Two, your dog needs severe training because nobody's gonna watch a dog that humps people. Three, technically what you did was considered kidnapping and I could have you arrested. Well, I'm gonna call the cops because you had my dog injured. I'm like, okay, you know what? Fuck it. You wanna play this card? I'll do it myself. So I take out my phone, I call 911. Fucking call the cops. Cops arrive in 3 minutes. And they had the nerve to ask me, oh, did you hurt his dog? And I explained, you know, everything. I even had the list that that man gave me. And the man had the nerve to say, oh no, he forged my signature. That's not my signature. I can't write in cursive. I even told the officer this, and the officer's like, look, we're not saying we don't believe you, but would you mind writing in cursive so we can go home? I'm like, yeah, I don't mind. I wrote my name in cursive. They looked at my name, looked at his note, and said, sir, his note looks nothing. Your note looks nothing like his writing. And guess what happened next? Oh no, the dog humped the officer's leg. Yeah. And the dude was like, oh, Glenn, you're not supposed to do that. He didn't have any boom in his voice. He didn't have any, none of that shit. No boom, no fucking, no demanding, no fucking ownership, none of that shit. The officer looked at him. They called animal control to come get his dog. And he fought tooth and nail. He's like, I don't know why the fuck you're taking my dog away. Take away that animal. He hurt my precious baby. I'm like, I'm not going to reiterate this, but technically you did kidnap me. And then the officers looked at him like, sir, is this true? He's like, no, he could have gone home at any time. I'm like, officers, he told me if I took 5 steps towards that door, he'd run in his room, grab his gun, and shoot my brains out. And he's like, no, I never said that. And I looked at him and I'm like, really? Really? You're gonna lie in front of these nice officers? Yeah, fuck you. And the officer asked me, he's like, son, how much did you do this job for? I'm like, honestly, $20. Because he said he'd be back in 2 hours. I've been here almost 10. The officer looked at him and he's like, sir, you do realize that... Oh, and they were like, sir, I want to hear your reason. And he put reason in quotes. And he's like, I was on my way home. Traffic was bad. I'm like, no. When you left, traffic was bad. And you said you'd be back at 5. Traffic clears up at 4:30. I should know. I live in this town. And he's like, you haven't lived here long enough to know. You don't even drive. I'm like, sir, I know more than enough in this town to know that unless there's an accident on the highway, traffic usually clears up about 4:30, 4:45. You didn't get home till almost 7 or 8. Don't play that shit with me. Even the officers agreed with me. And they're like, and they looked at me and they're like, sir, pay him what he's due. He's been a good sport about this. He could have said, fuck you, left at any time. You need to be a good sport about this. And he's like, fine. And he gave me $60. And I'm like, you know what? Fuck it. Keep your money. I'm not working for your ass anymore. Guess what happened a week later? Dipshit called me for another job. At that point, I'm like, you are one stupid motherfucker. Like, who in their fucking right mind would work for somebody who refuses to take responsibility for their own actions? Hi, Iraka. Hey, Skittles, did you install Arcadegeddon yet? Motherfucker! Eh, take your time. You have an airplane? What you do for a Klondike bar? I have to grab your butt cheeks and pull out my willy, stir your asshole like a hot bowl of chili. Welcome to the internet. Have a look around. Please 100 enemies with the ice blast skill. Why don't you just use the axe? Thank you. Wait, who's asking you to stop typing? Gee, I wonder why. I know. I was being a smart ass. Oh, so I told one of my friends about me doing the parrot sounds and kind of talking shit about you. And my friend is like, why are you doing that to them? And I'm like, they think it was funny. And you know, I'm not really serious about doing that. I saw that TikTok with this dude's trying to make food in the microwave. He's like, shh, why the fuck are you so loud? Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. You already live like this. Ooh. Don't look at me like that. Also, I saw that duet you did. Oh my god, the way that you, like, the ending to that was fucking hilarious. Buckle up, sweetheart. I mean, if you want to redo it in your car, I'm not gonna judge you. You had like actual internet in your house. There. Then when tomorrow comes, you'd be like, I need to clean. Yeah, I'll get away until another day. Oh, Dragon Ball Xenoverse. Yeah, come on in. How do I do that? I know if you send a request, it'll pop up saying one person with it. There we go. Did I do it right? Thought I did. Oh, there we go. Oh, I've already had one. And I almost had a major breakdown today. And your jobs is not doing... And your job's not doing shit? Yeah, and at that point you can tell him, well, this is a normal occurrence and he keeps doing this and it's making me uncomfortable. Oh, Arcadegeddon. Dude, it is so much fucking fun. Yeah, leveled up! Hey, Sophie. Are you? Chrissy, wake up. I don't like this. Chrissy, wake up. There you are. Come here. I see you, green motherfuckers. Come here. Hi, Mara. Because he thinks he can harass you and get away with it.
Are you ready?
I'm pretty sure his type is dom women who are out of his league. Pretty sure he was following you. In his mind, he probably thinks he's your future owner. Wait, he wants you to give him what? Honestly, I don't know why the fuck it's any of his motherfucking business what side to play for. He's not your boyfriend, he's never gonna be your boyfriend, he's the fuck off and get a life. That's Saito for you. Okay, so my theory on this is the fact that black women are being more approached by men because of the fact that men are trying to go back to like the fucking slavery times. He was trying to claim you as his. Yeah, because it's not that big of a game. Oh, that's completely understandable. Okay, that's nice. Fuck off. At that point, it's just like, that is basically him admitting that he would do that, because who the fuck just walks up to somebody and says, you got a boyfriend? Yeah, I got a boyfriend. I'd still fuck you. What kind of bullshit is that? That is bullshit. Aha, dry. I'm monogamous, motherfucker. Why did you go get a sex toy? At that point in time, if they that point in time, if people are so desperate to get laid, they should just get a sex toy. Okay, at that point, next time he approaches you, just say, just, you know, call the cops, say this man tried to rape me. I'm surprised you said the words I said this since I admire your desperation. Senpai will fuck you up. The friends will fuck you up. And his, in his eyes, when you say turn off, he sees, he says turn on. An endeavor. At this point in time, he's an endeavor. That's what he is. That's what he is. That's what he is. He's a fucking endeavor. What am I gonna fire you for? I'm about to slap this dude 6 shades from Sunday and turn him 7 colors of the rainbow. Taste the rainbow, motherfucker! Damn. Oh, you are not ugly. Walk like a man, talk like a man. I'm the fucking Lizard King. Wait, are you? So you're asexual. Got it. I learn new things about my friends every day. Because in their mind, they believe that when a woman... It's because of the whole bullshit, hold on, let me pause my game. It's because of the bullshit movie trope that when a woman says no, men take it as yes, put them heads in the mindset of a movie like, oh yeah, she doesn't want me. Physically, she doesn't want me, but mentally, we're already married, have 2 kids, a white picket fence, and a fucking house. But in reality, I'm trying to get her to give me the attention that I believe I deserve from her. And if she doesn't give it to me, I'll keep pestering her to get it till she gives me the time of day. And then I'll take that opportunity to basically make my move and make her mine. That is the mindset of fucking men nowadays. give a damn. And we understand that. But you can't fucking put HIV in a needle and stick it in a dude's dick. I understand what you're saying. That was yourself, man. I'm going ghost. I've been invisible for several months now. No. No, because we can see you. It's icy thought on Thursdays. Hey, Toto Volk, you take 5 steps near me. I got a secret title with your name on it. Want to make the eyes match? Hey, Bakugo, I fucked your mom last night. I'm gonna be your new stepdad. Hey, Deku, I know where your daddy is. Now, we already know. We already know that's a bold-faced lie. If I wanted to say Tamaki's a terrible person, I would flat out say Tamaki's a terrible person. If you want to be a goldfish cracker, Saito, just lay back and get eaten. What the fuck? Oh, round 21? Nice. Blackjack. Nice. You must have a good fucking team on your hands. You must have had a good team on your hands. Well, now you got us. Now we not got Skittles and I. And we suck. Yes, you do, and Tamaki enjoys it. I'm not on the game right now. I'm on Arcadegeddon. I'll turn my stuff out. I'm on Arcadegeddon. It's one of the new games that's for free on PlayStation Plus. Hey, renewed man! What map is it? Oh! That's not a new map. That's one of the three maps you get to play on. Well, I mean, it's new to you then. It's a fun map. I prefer 9, though. Blah, blah, blah. No, they're children. What the fuck? What the fuck was that? Oh, that was my controller. We told you, you can't have those toys on live. Go get your package. We'll wait. I fucking love that! Skittles, the AFK on me, fucking bitch! That's the life! Hello! That's the fucking life! That's the life of Black Ops! People gonna fucking AFK your ass! What, zombies? If you play Blood of the Dead, which is should be the physical one, they come in from my world. Downstairs, there's two walls in the back, left and right, that they come through. Upstairs, there's two broken windows. All I hear is nothing but head. And I'm like, this is not that kind of party. Oh my. Dumb bullshit, I heard what you fucking said. That's what you should do. You behave yourself. Don't get distracted. You have to figure out how to switch your guns before you start a match. They're not going to. Everywhere. Skittles. Skittles, are we really gonna help Saito? Because she just said if that dude falls again, she's not gonna get him back up. Makes me think how she's gonna act when we play with her. She'll leave our ass. Damn. This is not in Yasha. Dad, we don't want to play with her anymore. I think Hayden might be a B.O.T. Sorry, give me a minute. Okay. Instagram's starting to bug me. Hey, Bloodbath! I did not see that dude. How long have you been in the corner, buddy? Sorry, I'm playing one of my games right now, and one dude just like hid in the corner. Okay. Oh shit, dude, downstairs. Yo. I'd be better if my landlord didn't pull some shady shit today. Dude, go for it. An angry brow. Oh, I thought it was like a unibrow. Oh, nice. I mean, you know, you do what you gotta do and you have fun with it. Oh shit! Oh, my friend Saito's in the box. I thought Skittles had to go get the mail. I thought Skittles had to go get the mail because she was talking about that. Oh, nice! And this is why I love you guys. Dude, you should so make a vampire character. So a demon doused with holy water, or a nun turned rogue doused with holy water. Oh, what, a nun turned rogue? I thought that's what Sister Sin was. Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. So I went to this place that's not near my house, but kind of somewhat close. And I was looking for an album for one of my friends, and it's a Ghost album. They said that they had it in stock, but I looked through the vinyl records and they didn't have it in stock. And then I asked him, like, "Hey, you guys don't have it in stock. You should, like, at this location?" And he's like, "Look, you know, the way that the store is made up, it's basically like a scavenger hunt. Like, everything is labeled as used." And he was like, "Well, if you're looking for it, it's gotta be either there. If it's not there, it's either at a warehouse or, you know, it's either at a warehouse or the other location." And I'm like, okay. And I end up like, "So what album were you looking for?" And I'm Wait, Ghost Replay. Yeah. Yeah, that's basically what the that store is. Damn. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, if you get a certain drink in that game and you drink it, zombies, when you kill them, they'll float upwards. But so the album I was looking for my friend is called it's basically by Ghost, and it's called Hunter's Moon. And that was basically what I was kind of like a man on a mission searching for. What the fuck? This is why I love these guys. No. All right. I believe they're trying to still process it. What are you doing in my swamp? You ain't so- No, you can't say sorry now. And you thought Jason was bad. I'm gonna be so ecstatic when she finally fights the tigers. Oh my. Fucking talking shit about zombies while you crawl away from them. Good lord. I'm running low on ammo. I don't care. Fucking hell. They don't wait for shit. Ding 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 ding. I want that booty. Oh. just ask somebody why their feet so big? No, you won't. You're gonna die stubborn. Power Rangers! That's your ass, Mr. Postman! Stage 4 complete. Blah, blah, blah. Lazy. Lazy. This bitch empty. Skittles ain't normal. On Amazon? That's 8 pounds. Make it seem like it's a racial thing. What did you order something? Ah, my freaking foot. Adiansha. Yeah. Oh, you didn't order it? Do it. Do it. Get out the way. Well, put it in your Amazon wish list and maybe somebody will buy it for you. Yeah, we know. You float too. Gumbuddy. Yeah, you're gonna have to find the Pack-a-Punch. We have a drill? Hey, I like RE Village. They do the same thing. They do the same thing of Resident Evil 4 and 5 and 6. Yeah, because bullets are a good source of iron. They are immortal to an extent. fucking shit. That's some bullshit. Go home. Why? You don't think you did Tamaki justice? There's a new one. Oh, I was about to say, why don't you just do Pie Thomas? Huh? You don't need rainbow contacts, you just need something rainbow related. Oh, and sorry. Also, what would Tamaki be on the Alphabet Mafia spectrum? This is true. But he doesn't let anybody get close to him. And it only took 4 seconds. Which one? Damn. Yeah, y'all so sweet for that. Y'all so gay for that too, but wow. Are you ready? Damn. I was? Oh, I remember that now. You shouldn't have opened the catwalk. But you learned your lesson that day. Well, now you know what it is. Fucking hell. If you're not overrun and completely ass eaten by zombies. Call me, beat me if you want to reach me. Yeah, and then when it is you, then it's funnier. What did Mineta do this time? Oh shit. Oh, he fucked. He's fucked. Fucking Deku. All I gotta say is rest in pieces, Mineta, because yeah, not even Recovery Girl can put your ass back together. What hospital bed? If he gets Detroit smashed by Deku, game fucking over. It was at that moment. Denki had no idea how badly. Sorry, Mineta didn't know how badly he fucked up. Yeah, at that point in time, Mineta stealing Uraraka's bra is immediate forfeit to life. Because we all know who Uraraka would go to in that fucking moment in time. And he's not gonna be happy. Imagine if it was Bakugo who found it out first. Skittles, we gotta let her drown first before we can let her swim. Don't worry, we'll help you after you die in a couple more matches. Don't worry, like I said, we'll help you as soon as you die in a couple more matches. Well, a couple more because I'm not done with my game yet. You're the one to talk. Shots fired. I'm sorry, Skittles. I can't go to your funeral now. You're going to pieces. You should. I'm sorry, Skittles. I love you, but I cannot protect you from Saito's rage after you just said that. Yeah, once one person unlocks the shield, everybody else can go and grab one. How much time you've been in alive for, because we've been in alive for almost an hour. Well, the Pack-a-Punch is usually in one of three areas depending on what map you're on. There is no such thing as too early in that game. what you made me do. You know, funny enough, I see the exact same thing. Perfectionist motherfucker. You always say, no more editing, but what happens 5 minutes later? Oh, I gotta edit some more. I gotta be perfect. Well, whose fault was that? Come through, come on. Oh shit. You say that now, but wait till a whole horde of zombies comes after your ass.
Hurt.
Hang on a minute. Okay, I'm starting to semi-dislike Instagram's lives because you're gonna go live for a fucking hour! Stuck here? Whee! I always hated that area because you never fucking leave when you need to. Motherfucker. Yeah, I'm starting to dislike Instagram's live rules. Like, apparently you can only go live for an hour at a time. This does not make it a good substitute for TikTok. That's not bad, it's actually really good. Nine map. Yeah, nine map's good. And the fucking packer, the packer punch is actually at the very bottom of that level. Actually, those chances come quite frequently. But it depends on your team. Like, if you're the last one left and there's like a horde of zombies, then you're fucked. I wonder why Skittles hasn't come back yet. Probably. That's messed up. Oh, she's standing up with me. That's so sweet. I don't need you up here, though. Probably because they had enough points for it. Ah, I'm dead. I'm looking at you. Fuck you. I'm alive. I'm dead again. I'm up. I'm going faster than a bitch around the house, boy. Boo. Dude, I'm hungry, but I don't know what I want to eat. You got a problem with chocolate cake? And you say we're picky. We're not talking about the sex life here, love. What? Could what? I don't like your girlfriend, too bad, I guess I'll get a new one. You know, Skittles, that explains why they don't come after you. You are threatening. We don't have to explain shit. We don't have to explain jack shit. Code Tamaki, we got a code Tamaki. Yeah, Skittles making a way. Never say that again in your life. think it's called gibberish. They're on your shit list. All these squares make a circle. All these squares make a circle. Well, good thing it's not a young lady. It's Pennywise! Fucking hell.
Thank you.
Hey Skittles, I think Saita might be better than we are. Yeah, I think she's better than we are, Skittles. You are Satan. Well, Skittles, I guess she doesn't really need us to play with her. Well, I mean, I gotta finish this run or die doing it, or I could just leave it any given time. But I want to finish my mission first. Yeah, like if it takes you a while to finish making a fucking video. Yeah, I don't think she needs it. She got the level, she got to round 38. Yeah, she'll be fine. Your ass, Mr. Postman. Thank you.
What? Where the fuck do you find something like that? When are any of us gonna go to the coral reef? Oh, that explains a lot.
I probably should eat something.
I'm not going to be able to do that.